Dual graph. So this is what this space allocation problem is, that we have given the n rooms, and then we have given the width and length of each room and the adjacency relations among the rooms. And the problem, especially in terms of rectangular floor plans, the problem is to fit the given rooms inside the rectangle while satisfying the dimensional and the topological constraint. So if we see the dimensional constraint, they are more kind of the optimization problem, and if we see the topological constraint, it's more of graph theoretical approach. So already two big mathematical domains are involved here. So floor plan design layout, so obviously it's a multi-constraint problem. So we have the topological constraint, dimensional constraint, and then there can be many, many other constraints which are put by the user or by the architects, like the view and the daylight and many other things. So initially we are concerned with the topological and the dimensional constraints only, and then maybe we can leave it to the architect that they can modify the results which we are proposing. So there can be two approaches, like one is to consider the dimensional and the topological constraints simultaneously, and the other is to first concentrate on topological constraint and then consider the dimensional constraint. So what I am working is I am using the second approach. So now we introduce the concept of the best connected rectangular floor plan. So we have seen that we have an adjacency graph, and then for the adjacency graph we can obtain a rectangular floor plan. So this is not like we have the design brief given adjacency graph, then we can obtain a rectangular floor plan, and then it has the design solution adjacency graph which we call the VQL. So now I proved mathematically that this weak dual or the design solution adjacency graph can have at most 3n minus 7 edges, where n is the number of the rooms. So idea is to obtain a solution which has the maximum connectivity, because connectivity is I think very important criteria in any design. So which has the maximum connectivity, and if we look directly for this, so at some point of time the idea is that all the given adjacency graph should be contained in this solution. If it is possible, then we don't have to look for the given adjacency graph. We can directly say that, okay, we are already considering this solution which has maximum connectivity. So that's why we don't have to look for the connectivity every time. So for example, if we consider the 4 rooms, then for n is equal to 4, 3n minus 7 is equal to 5. So if you see both the solutions, and if you draw the graph for them, the number of edges would be 5. But in the first solution, now for 5 rooms, the number of edges should be 8. So in the first solution, the maximum number of edges can be 5, and in the second solution, for n is equal to 5, the maximum number of edges should be 8. So if we have to move from 5 to 8, it means that we have to put the next room in a way that it should be adjacent to 3 of the existing rooms. So if we see the first solution, wherever we put the rectangular room, it can be adjacent to at most 2 rooms, and in the second solution, it can be adjacent to 3 rooms, at least in this side or not on the other side. So what I want to say is that the idea is to design an algorithm which always guarantee that at the end, independent of the number of the rooms, we have the best connected rectangular floor plan. So choose the number of the rooms, and then there should be a compositional schema which should be generated automatically such that it should be best connected. So there are mainly two very common approaches which has been used for the generation of the rectangular floor plans. So one is what we call dissection, and the other is the addition. And in both, we can see that at the end we are getting the same composition schema. So we are using the second approach. So this is the algorithm which we developed to have the best connected floor plans for any given number of the rooms. So we call it CRLAP algorithm. So in this algorithm, we start with first two rooms in the center. So you can say that first and second rooms are in the center. Then the third will come on the right, the fourth will be left, then above and then below. So it's, that's why the name is CRLAP algorithm. And it can be always verified mathematically that the computational schemas which we obtain from this algorithm are always best connected. So I'm not showing you how they are best connected, but it can be verified. So the what approach we discussed earlier is that first we look for the topological constraint, and so that means that the best connected solution, and then we introduce the dimensional constraint. So introduce the dimensional constraint. So if we have the rooms of the different areas, so it means that at the end we have some extra spaces if the area of all the rooms are different. And that's why we introduce the extra spaces in a way that the composition always remains rectangular, but at the same time we have developed some optimization techniques so that the area of the extra spaces should be minimum. So these are the two techniques which we developed. So one is the order of the allocation. It means that the way in which the rooms are arranged, because like suppose we have the five rooms, so you can start with any rooms and you can end with any of the rooms. So there should be some order in which the rooms are arranged, and then we can swap the width and height of the rooms to reduce the extra spaces. So at the end of the day, the area of the room would remain constant. So by swapping the width of height and by considering the order of the allocation, to pick the solution which has the minimum extra spaces, we can have the best connected rectangular floor plan which always guarantee the minimum area extra spaces. So this is the example that we have given, the four rooms, their width and height, and using the CRLAP algorithm we developed this rectangular floor plan. So again, using the algorithm, I am just showing an example for the four rooms, but using the algorithm we can design very complex buildings like the hospitals which have 50 or 100 rooms. So using the same algorithm we can develop the rectangular floor plan independent of the number of the rooms, and then using the optimization techniques we can see the difference that both are developed through CRLAP algorithm, but the area of the first one is 968 and the area of the second one is 1786. So we can see that by just having the two operations we can reduce the area of the extra spaces that much. So the future work is to identify the other best connected composition schema so that the architect or the user can have the many different choices. And the idea is to consider the other architecture constraints. That's why now I am in the architecture department, so that I can know other architecture constraints and to identify the circulation paths. These are the references.